Hello. Sorry. All right. How's everyone's evening? You all hear me all right? Hope you can anyway. We are racing the Team Italy Gladiators race. MYK Derek, first one's to comment. Nice one. I will try and suffer as best as possible. I also thought I'd start the stream a little bit earlier tonight as I could get a bit of talking out the way because the race might finish a bit late. Well, not a bit late, but about half 8. So I thought if I ride a bit now, talk a bit now, and then I won't have to afterwards so much. Because I think I'll try and cram in a few more intervals after the race, as crazy as that sounds. I'll repeat that a few more times during the race just to pre mentally prepare myself. So as much as like the race will be hard, I don't think I want to be completely empty in the tank during the race. So I don't know why, but I haven't got sound on. By the way, prep is going well for this weekend for the team launch. Looking forward to that, and hopefully we can do a live stream there of the British Champs race. It'll be nice because it'll be a different background for you. You won't have my mum and dad's conservatory, which I am very thankful for, I gotta say. We've got 15 minutes until the start of the event, so I'll jump on for 10 minutes and then I'll just line up. So I wanted to check something. Checking on YouTube. I even want to try and get. I'm gonna bring the mic with me as well to the race this weekend so that I can possibly talk during the race. Okay, I'm not gonna be able to solve that. So, 25 watching. Brilliant. Starting to build a little bit. Jimbo Jet, good luck. Thank you. I've had a busy day. I'll tell you all about it now. Just jump on the turbo. Oh, I'm getting old. I'm joking. I'm not getting old. I better open the window. Cheers, Hev. So, yeah, busy day. Doing non-cycling things. This is the my first ride of the day. Had to take the car back to the garage to have the driver's airbag changed, actually. Apparently there's a big fault to them. So had to be recalled. I was there for like an hour and a half waiting, so managed to do quite a bit of stuff on my phone, which is where I kind of do a lot of my, I guess you call it, just messaging people on social media, Instagram and Twitter mainly. Creating some posts, creating some content. I've got an infographic going out later on Instagram, actually. I'll post it when I get off. Talks about when the best time to stop your intervals. So, like, what's the best time to, like, if you're doing a 20-minute effort, 10-minute effort, 1-minute effort, whatever, there is actually, like, some science behind it. So that'll be interesting to read. A lot of it is kind of my research that I've read, a lot of literature, and just want to pass it on. So, evening Dave, evening Rich, fingers crossed. Yeah, well, we're not going to be posting brilliant times tonight. Who am I kidding? Yeah, we're gonna do a solid ride tonight. Being this the first kind of ride of the day, I'm quite pumped to do something rather than just sitting around doing work on a laptop. So I appreciate like you guys tuning in right now, because usually, you know, I've not even started. So, feel free to leave the live stream, obviously, because the race won't start for another 10 minutes. And yeah, actually, 10 minutes exactly. So, feel free to leave and come back in about half an hour's time. You should be able to catch it the last 10 minutes of the race, maybe. Conscious of your time. Don't want to keep you. But of course, if you want to see exactly what happens, you can watch it all live. Of course, you could always watch it back later. Yeah, XP points all day long. I did a race in a week where I think I got nothing but XP points. I think this race tonight is zero power ups, which I don't think I've ever raced a race with no power ups. So it could spell disaster for a lot of people, but it might well suit me. My warm up is nothing special, really. It's just spinning the legs. Yeah, I would do obviously a proper warm-up, but in terms of, you know, the time we've got, and you know, obviously the race is going to be quite hard, but it won't be hard initially. I'm just gonna stick to a really steady warm up. Spinning the legs. As cliche as that sounds, I hate saying it. But yeah. Letting the terrain do the work. As you can see, my power's going up. Chris. Whoa. All right, so what I've basically done is kind of artificially raise my heart rate there. There's very little power going through the pedals. I'm actually really warm now. Just from 8 minutes of like really high cadence, so yeah, it does work. It does work. So we've got some teammates in this race, which I found out only about 2 hours ago. We've got Gus, Team Cycling Hub, and we've obviously got the we've got Ash Beach as well. So, you know, whether or not teamwork will come into this, I have no idea, but at the end of the day, this course is the, it's one lap of the course that we'll eventually do two laps of next week. So we're going to go up the longer side of the Epic QM, no, not the Epic QM, the short QM, that 1.5 minute climb. And yeah, and then we come up the short way and before the finish. So it will be interesting to say the least. Hey Chris, it will be great to see you there if you can make it. Come say hi. I will be happy to meet you. Yeah. Do it for Wales. Yeah. Alright, 2.5 minutes. Right, didn't get any power ups. So, oh wait, there's no power ups anyway, is there? See me. Anyway, started the Swift Companion app, which is very handily placed on my iPad, it makes it a lot easier. I guess if there's no power apps, it doesn't matter. Don't really need to keep the legs fit in, to be honest. Just gonna rest. Turn the heart rate down. At the end of the day, it's still energy expending, so. Yeah, as good as your warm up is, you're still expending energy. I'd just like to stop for a minute or so. Just to bring the heart rate down a bit. Right, best of luck everyone, and remember if you are actually following on the Zwift Companion app or actually watching on the Zwift itself, remember to give other people kudos as well, they deserve it as much as me. Alright, here we go, see how hard this start is. How does it go power up? Man, I am fresh. That's not necessarily a good thing. You got the plumber. The plumber lives around here. Lives on my way. Oh, I don't like this. Off the back. There he is, there's a plumber. Oh, my legs are so fresh. So what's the kilo like? Are we sitting, are we low enough here? Keep getting dropped though, we go lower. Very little rest so far. I'm struggling to maintain a position. What the? So 250 watts feels easy, even if my heart rate is very active. My legs are very soft. So at the minute, I feel all right. I think we're about to hit the climb, are we? I'm gonna move up. Remember, the first part of the climb is always hard for me. So I need to try and get used to going hard at the bottom. We'll try it today. Only if you cheer me on. I'm kind of slipping back. What is going on? If you're going to move up, do it in one big one. All day long. All day long. At the front for the descent. Good position. Let's make it count. And hang on and go over the top. Ready? a drink. By the way, don't pay any attention to my heart rate. Don't pay attention to anybody's. It's so variable. So today I feel fresh as hell, but which means I'm getting up to 170 very easily. Now on a tired day, I'd be struggling at 170. So take it with a pinch of salt. Never ever look at a rider's heart rate unless you know exactly what the parameters are. This looks to be a fun coupe with a few coupes. Certain groups come together. That boy Gus is still here. I don't know if Ash is racing. Does someone clarify? Come on, Gus. Up, 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 up. Keep it going, keep it going. He's away. He's got a gap. Good on, Gus. Young kid. Doing well. what I've noticed from like racing the other cycling hub and Wahoo boys is how good they are at like resting, because in these races, you know, you can rest because the pace tends to, you know, kind of drift. But then I guess in the Super League, the races are very much kind of flat out, so recovering is quite hard, which is probably where I'm going to struggle next week. See how low I can bring that heart rate. Ah, 128. And then it drifted back. Hard to judge on a course like this, like who's gonna do well, because the first climb is different to the second climb. Oop. pay attention. There's a break going. Come on. We're in the zone. Let's make it hard. It's gonna be a sprint finish again. Actually, because we've got no power-ups, let's try and do the sprint. that was brilliant from me. Even if I do say so myself, that was good. Like, I've not been able to do that before. Let's take a look. Not bad, that was it, guys. Not bad. In fact, fair play to Gus. It was good from Gus. Being a youngster, he's going to have a good sprint. That's generally how it works. Yeah. That was good. No ash power issues. Ah, no. Unlucky. Hope he's watching, anyway. Ah. Nice one, Gus. Nice. Come on, Gus. Can't spell. Gus. Nice one, Gus. Brilliant. I'm pedaling, but nothing's happening. I'm just going to stay here. Quick little recap. As you saw at the end, that went really well. Not a sprinter, but I think that might be a PB there, at least for 2018. For those last 20 seconds, it was pretty much like on the limit, but looking forward to getting on the road bike and like being able to sprint the drops and things, or even being able to sprint out on the road would be really nice. But felt brilliant, so I think I'm gonna do like a few more like 1 minute efforts, and then train again tomorrow. So everybody's wishing Gus a great ride. Wishing Gus a great ride. Congratulating Gus on a great ride. Yeah, very good. Oh. Right. Shall I stream my 1 minute efforts or not? Do you know what? Let's just go. Let's just do them. Gus, you didn't do anything wrong. That's the name of the game, man. You just follow your moves. Doesn't matter if I'm a teammate, you're just following. Like, in this game, you're just gonna be a tentative all the time. So even if like I make a move, you still need to be producing power in case, you know, a group of five come away with me. So it's always worth being alert, so you don't have to apologize for anything, mate. Good ride. Oh, Hadi. Terrible. You missed it. You can watch me do my 1 minute effort now, though. And then when I stop the live stream, you can go back and watch it. I don't know. I don't want to go that way. Okay, man. No. Yeah. Which way am I going? I'm turning left on it. No. Useless. I'll turn around. This is super precarious. Okay, well. That's the one. Getting it in today, finishing off strong. Try and keep this consistent. Need to do this more often. So I'll mix it up. So I'll do that 1 minute. I'm gonna do some 20-20s the next time up now. And then I'll finish with a, I don't know what I'll finish with. Not that it's, I'm not making it up as I go along, but I do my own training now, so I tend to segregate some days into different kind of effort. I don't know how long this rest has been. Lost count. You've got to keep your recovery. Can't stress that enough. Alright, some 20-20s to the top. then we'll call it at the top, see what we're like for another day tomorrow, so there's no need to do too much. Oh, the slower I go, the more the hill I got. One more. Let's go. One more. See you, Chris. Cheers, honey. Although I'm doing efforts after a race, it's like you can do it too. It's not like you're incapable of doing it. You'll just get to a certain level where you're capable of doing that bit more. I mean, obviously it depends which race you do, so I'm not just saying you could do it after an hour and a half of racing, but you know, particularly if you know the race is only half an hour or something like today, you can easily just bolt on a few extra effort. The 2020s or the 30-30s whatever you want to call them, they are by far the best to do after after a race, purely because in terms of the actual overall effort, there's actually very little, but the actual workload is a lot. So instead of riding like an hour at zone 3 or doing some zone 4 effort, you're actually doing a lot of anaerobic work in a very short space of time. So in terms of what to do afterwards, these are actually quite good. So tomorrow, I'm more than likely going to be doing another Zwift race, but a bit of endurance on zone 3 beforehand. Really working on like my lactic tolerance, being able to do a race afterwards, as opposed to, you know, hitting a race fresh like I was today. But I'm gonna end it there. Appreciate you watching. Hit that thumbs up button, subscribe, leave a comment if you haven't already, and maybe I'll see you tomorrow. If not, have a good ride. If you're riding, if you're working, I'm sorry, but I still hope you have a very good day. All right, see ya.